I think that's in focus. Hey guys, welcome back to another VFX tutorial. Today we're going to be taking a look at how to create Magic Energy Ball VFX inside of HitFilm. Now you can do this inside of HitFilm Express, but we're going to be using the Particle Simulator. So you'll need the 3D Particles add-on if you want to follow along.
So here's the setup for the final shoot. I've got the camera here in the kitchen, and then about maybe 10, 15 feet away is this other equipment. So I've got the fan to get some atmosphere going. I've got a reflector to bounce light onto my face, which is coming from the window. I've got the green screen, which has a green light on it, and this orange one provides sort of a side light here. And that's pretty much it. And it's pretty cramped in here, but I think it'll work.
So we're not gonna go over how I did the green screen because we've done that in tutorials before. And the background was created using stock images and Unreal Engine 4. The focus of this tutorial will just be the energy ball VFX. But if you have any questions about the other techniques I used, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Let's open up HitFilm and get started. The energy ball that you see in the final VFX shot is made of basically three different parts. Let's create the first one now. What I'll do is come up to New Composite Shot, and I'll call this Energy Ball Core. And the final project was in 4K, but I'll go ahead and make it 1080p. Then I'll make the height 1920 so that it's a square, and hit OK. Let's go ahead and bring in the Particle Simulator. And you can see if I hit play that we've got a spawn of particles in the middle. Come over here to the controls panel on the left, and under emitters, change the shape to circle. Basically, what this means is that the particles will come from a circle shape instead of a single point. You can increase the size of that circle if you want. Under trajectory, I'll change it from random to explode so that the particles go outwards. And then I'll go into the particle systems, under movement, and set the speed to something much higher, around 2000. This is going to cause the particles to fly off screen. To create that sort of back and forth motion between the particles, I used a force. So let's go ahead and add that using the plus icon here. Under the force settings, change the type to attraction. Because the force has a center of 000, that means it's at the center of the screen. So the particles will first explode outwards and then be attracted to this force, which is in the center, which will cause the back and forth waving motion. The particles are dying a bit soon. They're kind of reaching the edge, but then they're popping off screen. So let's go ahead and go into the system and increase the life to maybe something like 3 or 4. There we go. So now we have a back and forth motion to the particles. They are still popping in and off screen, which I want to prevent. Select the particle system, then come over to the lifetime panel. Come down to alpha, and then change the type to gradient. This gradient represents the transparency of the particles over their lifetime. So right now it's white the whole time, which means it's going to have a solid opacity throughout the entire lifespan. If I come in here and click to add a point at the beginning and end, this will make the particles fade in and out as they're born and as they die, which makes for a smoother transition. Now for the texture, I'll come into the appearance section and change the texture source to built-in. For the texture, I'll use Fire Ferocity 1. Now let's introduce some variation in the particles by coming down to the Appearance Variation section. I'll increase the texture angle per second. This will make them spin over time. And then I'll set the texture angle to 1. This means that the particles can be rotated in any degree from 0 to 360. Then I'll come down to Movement Variation and maybe adjust the life and the scale a little bit, and maybe the speed as well. These settings are up to you, but they introduce variation in the movement of your particles. I'll go ahead under General and add a few more particles per second so that we have some more on screen. And then in the Transform properties, I'll just lower the scale of the whole system so that it stays within the box. I'll increase the scale a bit under Movement and fine-tune the particles per second to match. Cool, so that's pretty much set. Now, if you want to introduce more variation, what you can do is duplicate this particle system since you already have it set up, and then come down into General and change the seed. This will make a different simulation. And then you can change the texture, you can change basically whatever you want, and it will have a lot of the settings that we've already set up. So maybe I'll choose a more subtle texture like Shockwave, and maybe I'll increase the life so that they last a bit longer. You can add as many of these particle systems as you want to introduce variation. Now what I'll do is add a distortion, so you have four that you can choose from: energy, fluid, heat, and smoke. I'm going to use heat in this case, but you can use whichever looks best to you. And then I'll play with the settings a bit to distort the particles so that they're not as uniform throughout. I might also add a diffuse as well to soften them up. And don't forget to turn on motion blur down here because the particles are moving, so they should be quite blurry. And that's pretty much it for this first section of the particle system. Now we can move on to the next one, which is creating the light rays that come off of it. So I'll come back into the media panel and select new again. And I'll name this one Energy Ball Starfish because that's what it looks like. So for this, what I'll do is create a new plane layer. And onto this, I'll drag the light flares effect. In the controls panel, I'll drop down the hotspot position and set it to 0, 0 so it's perfectly centered. Then I'll change the flare type down to microparticle streak. And you can see we get a lot of extra bits on the side here. In this case, I don't want those to appear, so I can turn them off by going into other elements and setting the brightness to 0. This will leave us with just the rays. Next, I'll drop down the hotspot and decrease the brightness almost all the way, but then increase the brightness of the rays themselves all the way up, so that we're left with less of a hotspot and more of just the light rays. Now I'll drop a hue, saturation, and lightness effect, and drop the saturation all the way down to 0. So the shape is there, but it's a little bit sharp. If I zoom in here, you can see that the texture itself is very sharp. So I'm gonna decrease that a bit with a radial blur effect. And since that happens in the center, that's where it will take place. You can increase this as much as you want to soften the effect. Maybe I'll also add another diffuse as well. To make this flare spin over time, what I'll do is come down into the ray section again and keyframe the rotation. So I'll activate keyframes at the start, skip to the end, and then set this to 1x over. Now to introduce variation similar to the particles, what I'll do is duplicate the flare and then offset the rotation by something a little bit more random. And then I'll increase or decrease the quantity scale. Basically, you just want to make it look different from the first flare, so that when you play them together, they appear to move as two different pieces. You can play with the length scale and the width as well if you want to get a different look. I might duplicate it once more and make some smaller flares. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and add a light rays effect onto the same plane and change the blend to screen. Increase the radius until you start to see the light rays and then adjust the intensity to fit your scene. When we set this to screen in the composite, not a lot of it will disappear because not a lot of the screen is black right now. So what I'll do is add a quick curves effect and increase the contrast quite a bit. You can come back and adjust this later if it doesn't work. Now, some extra things you can add to make it look a bit more unique are the heat distortion options. So I'll go ahead and do that. As well as maybe a twirl. This one you want to keep quite subtle because otherwise it's pretty obvious. And I'll just go ahead and decrease the scale a bit on all of these so that they don't reach the edge as much. For the last piece of the energy ball, we're going to use a free stock video from Rocket Stock. This is a collection of paint overlays that they've released for free and which you can find in the description. Because this is a stock video, we have to do a bit of work to make it look seamless. So let's go ahead and do that now. What I'll do is create a new comp and I'll make this the regular 1920 by 1080 and I'll bring the paint into that. Right click, transform and fit to frame width just so that we can see all of it. And basically the end result that I want to get is to add a polar warp and have the paint sort of moving either inwards or outwards, depending on what you're going for. You can see that there are two problems. The first is the seam down here on the bottom because it's not a perfect texture. And you can see that both the inner and outer edges aren't feathered, which makes for a bit of a rougher effect. So we want to be able to feather those and we want the transition to be seamless. So I'll go ahead and take off the polar warp effect. And basically what we need to do is create a texture that is seamless out of this video. So what I'll do is come over to the transform properties and adjust the position so that the crosshair here is on the exact left side of the screen. And in this case, that's -960. which is half of 1920, which is the width of our comp. Then what I'll do is duplicate it and move that X position to positive 960. So basically what we've done is we've taken our video and we've scooted it over to the left, but we've had the other side of the video come in on the right. Now what we can do is duplicate the footage once more and reset its position to zero and then draw a mask in the center here. So I'm holding down the Alt key to draw from the center and I'll just position it over the seam here. Then under Shape, feather it to make the blend a bit smoother. So it might not be easy to tell, but what we have here is a seamless texture. So if I select all of these and make them into their own comp, I'll call this Paint Seam Fix. Then if I go back into this comp and add the polar warp effect, you can see that there is now no seam anywhere inside of the circle. Now to feather the edges, what I'll do is come up and select the rectangular mask tool and draw a shape right here in the center. This will cut a hole out of the center and also around the edges. And if I come in and feather that shape, you can see it affects both the inner and outer sides of the polar warp effect. You can adjust which part of the polar warp is cut out by moving the mask here. So if I move it down, you can see that only the outer edges will be feathered. If I move it all the way up, only the inner part will. And if I keep it in the center here, we'll get sort of a donut shape that is feathered on both sides. If you haven't already, you can also make the composite a square as well to keep things neat. So now we have the three parts for our energy ball and we can actually start building it. So to keep things moving smoothly, I'm going to use a picture of the background instead of a video because it is quite an intensive comp to render. So let's go ahead and bring in our core, outline, and starfish comps. And what I'll do to make this easier to control is create a new point layer, and we'll call this energy ball position, because that's what it's going to represent. Then I'll select all three of these comps and parent them to the point. So now if I move the point, all of the energy ball comps will move along with it. So this is how you would animate it to follow an actor's hand or to move around the screen. You would keyframe the position of this point. Let's go one by one here. So I'll start with the core. And you can see that it is already transparent, which is good. But I'll go ahead and set it to screen. You can also set it to add, depending on how you want it to blend with your scene. So to color this, what I'm going to do is add a curves effect. And I'll go ahead and add that directly to the core layer. Then in the controls panel, come down to the red channel and bring that down quite a bit. Come down to the green channel and bring that down as well. If you want, you can also add a little bit of green in the highlights, totally up to you. And now we have our color. So let's make it glow by adding a couple of these effects onto it. If you lower the threshold, more of the energy will be affected. But basically you tweak these settings as you need them. So I'll increase the radius to make it a bit softer, adjust the intensity, and maybe I'll go back and change the color a bit to fix it, make it a bit more blue. So that's a good starting point. Let's go ahead and move on to the other ones and we'll come back and fix it if needed. Let's turn on the starfish comp and I'll set the blend for that to screen again. And I'll make it a bit bigger so that the light rays are visible on the outside. I'll make the point a bit smaller so that the energy ball is a bit more like it was in the actual scene. And I'll show you another way to add color is the color vibrance effect. So I'll add that directly to the starfish and you can see it takes effect right away. But I'll go ahead and select a similar blue color. The vibrance is sort of the saturation that it is. Maybe I'll add another radial blur effect just to smooth it out a bit more. Let's go ahead and turn on the outline composite and you can see that already has a green tinge to it. So I'll go ahead and add a hue, saturation, and lightness and drop that down to zero to give us a good starting point. Then once again, I'll set the blend to screen and increase the size as I see fit. It's a bit sharp, so maybe I'll add a blur and or a diffuse. And to color this one, I'll use another curves effect. For this outline, I also lowered the opacity so that it's not as visible. More of a hint that it's there. And that's how you can create an energy ball in three steps. Obviously, I did a lot of tweaking for the sort of light rays and the color and trying to make it match a bit better. I would recommend adding a lens flare on top. You can also add lens dirt or more stock footage elements to help blend it a bit better. And again, if you want to move the energy ball around, you can use this single point layer. But yeah, that's about it for this video. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell for weekly filmmaking and visual effects tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.